If you keep looking at what everybody else is doing, you'll never really take the time to be you. Yeah, that's really important. I feel like everybody should know this. We get hung up on social media watching everybody else's life, and we forget to just live ours. So stop watching what everybody else is doing. Just take the time to be you. You don't know me.
What is the biggest misconception about you?
That Cass and I were involved. That never happened.
Wait. I have heard this for months, years, centuries. Can you confirm that this was not a thing? And just let's end it here.
That's never been a thing. Come on, Cass is like my brother. It's crazy that they thought that because I was so young and he had a wife then. But yeah, moving on.
Next, what's one of your favorite song lyrics of yours, and can you sing it for me?
Okay, actually, this is actually an unreleased song, but maybe, should I do a song that's released?
No, do an unreleased one, that's even better, yeah.
Okay. If you keep looking at what everybody else is doing, you'll never really take the time to be you. Yeah. That's really important. I feel like everybody should know this. We get hung up on social media watching everybody else's life, and we forget to just live ours. So stop watching what everybody else is doing. Just take the time to be you. Yeah.
I love that. And what trendy dish could you eat every day?
Honestly, all but doubles, yeah.
That's funny because Dwayne Bravo said the same thing without hesitation, just like he was like doubles. I guess doubles for me too, but I'm just like, I could do doubles or roti. Any of those I could literally eat every day. I need to learn how to make it actually.
There was a time I actually ate it every day.
Really? I don't know if this is normal, but I used to think to myself, like, if I, like, say I'd get in a fight when I was younger with my mom, I'd be like, okay, I'm going to be a vagrant. What is an effective meal that I could, that's cost effective that I could eat? And I would always think to myself, hops or doubles would carry me till the end of time. So that was like my menu if I was a vagrant and I got kicked out of the house, which I was a fine child. Like, that would have never happened. But I was like, hops or doubles, the best prices for a good deal. So,
yeah, facts.
Okay, so do you have any hidden talents?
Hidden talents? I think most people know this, but I sew. So, like, I design and stuff. And I do, like, decor. I don't think people know that part, but they know that I design. But I sew. Just because you design don't mean you sew. That is patience. So, yeah, I would say that's my hidden talent.
Okay, last question. If you were stranded on an island in the middle of nowhere, and you can have two people with you, who would you want to be stuck with?
I'd want to be stuck with my mom, Abby Blackman, and I want to be stuck with my manager, Anson. And reason, she's the kind of person that she can make a four-course meal out of anything, like salt. Like, she could literally make,
like, you could have sand on the beach and she'd be like, here's a four-course meal.
Like, she can make a four-course meal of anything. Like, she's so legit with it. Like, that's how my childhood did not feel like we were having hard times, because she was so, like, good at that, you know? And my manager, because he's so practical and he's just very matter-of-fact, okay, always have a plan, we're gonna get this done. So he's gonna find a way to get us off that island. That's just the person. He has those survival skills. Full 100. I know it. Yeah.
Right. Well, let's get into the music industry, especially in the Caribbean. And I actually wanted to bring up Anson because he's been your manager for a while. And I know that you guys had this plan where you wanted to make soca an actual genre in an international spectrum. So what else do you think needs to be done in order to do so? Because I feel like COVID has definitely set things back a bit, but do you think we're on the right track to get it there?
We are definitely on the right track to get it there. And I think what we need is we need everybody to be on the same page, because a genre cannot bust by one person. I can't bust soca. I need like myself and a barrage of other artists doing fire tunes, doing tunes that like connect with not just the Caribbean, but like worldwide. So we all need to be on the same page in terms of like what soca means and what it's supposed to do, because I feel like we've let Carnival really steer our content. And I think it's a great opportunity, the fact that we don't have Carnival this year, even though we're all sad. Okay, we know we're sad, but at the same time, this is an opportunity for us to do content that would resonate with people that have never heard about Carnival in their entire life. So I would say if everybody was just on the same page, like supporting each other, because that's something that is very much lacking, the support from fellow artists and from the industry, because we have a sort of fight down crab in a barrel industry. I think if everybody just gets on the same page, we'll definitely be okay.
I have, and many other people feel like, you know, Instagram and social media in general is a curated version of yourself, right? And I feel like you're always someone who, I don't see you editing your pictures with no Photoshop. I just see you posting real content of where you are, embracing, you know, different hairstyle, different looks. Can you talk to me about, were you always so body positive and self-loving, or was that something that you've grown into? Because you do get a lot of scrutiny and you do get sexualized a lot, especially being a female artist in the Caribbean and Trinidad especially. I know you talked about how the DJs, the promoters, all the creepiness that goes on behind the scenes, but I want to talk about you and the fact that exposing your body, putting a bikini picture, isn't necessarily you doing that for attention. I think it's really clear that we need to understand that being confident in your body, no matter what shape or size, is different from trying to sexualize your content.
Yeah, I'm so happy that you touched on this, because I've wanted to touch on this on my Instagram from time to time, but I always said I didn't want it to look like if I'm responding to a hater or responding to somebody that said something like off about me. But I think that's crazy that women, we live in this world where it's like we're just here being ourselves, and then somebody is gonna look at us and tell us, one, that's not real, two, like, they're gonna have the world of shit to say about you. And you know, the sad part is that it's mostly women. They're gonna tell you so many different things, and it's like, why can't you just love? Why can't you just like praise, appreciate? Like, that's why I make it my business on my social media itself to, oh, like if I think a girl looks good in her picture, I say, oh my God, you look great. Like, if I think anything, like, I'm just gonna say it, because I don't think there are enough content of that by women being said on social media. I bring it, I bring it, I bring it, I bring it, I bring it.